Hi, this is Mohit Kamath and you're watching Smart Badminton channel. I'm your smart coach and today you all can see. We are talking about the Pullela Gopichand who won the All England Badminton Championships in men's singles category in the year 2001. Today we are going to see his strategies, his intelligence on court and the fantastic match winning points he has won. And all about his journey in that whole tournament. Let's quickly dive to today's match. Before we start off our match, I want all of you to see the men's singles draw, which is here in front of me, and we can watch. If you see here, Pullela Gopichand was, I believe, sixth seeded. You can see here he played Ronald Susilo from Singapore, I believe. So that was a straight set which he won. Then he played Colin Houghton of Denmark. That was also quite comfortable. It looks like quite comfortable, 15-7 and 15-4, and then. He played Ji Jingpeng. I think he is the Olympic champion, so 2000 Olympic champion, and he has won quite easily, 15-3 and 15-9. Fantastic. And then if you can see here, it was a semi-finals match between Peter Gade and Pullela Gopichand, and I believe that's 15. He played Anders Boysen, he played Anders Boysen, and then he goes for the semi-finals match. And if you see here, the most important factor, a lot of people say, a lot of expert has said this, that Taufik Hidayat, he was the most anticipated player to win that particular year All England Championship, men's singles. And he lost to Anders Boysen, 15-13 and 15-10. That was a quite shock. If he would have come for the semi-finals, then the story would have been different. And now you see, this is the semi-final match. The score was... it's 17-14 and 17-15. It could have been anybody's match, right? And... you can see here, Peter Gade... played the first three. Oliver Pongratz, I think he's from Poland. That's what the flag looks like. Maybe I don't know. I'm sorry. Definitely European. So there was a three game, and Peter Gade played a three game here, the third round. Then also with Roni Augustinus, two straight games, and then somewhat this round, if you see, played with Chen Yu. And that was quite comfortable. And then he meets Pullela Gopichand. So when you see this rally, this is the first game rally. You can see Gopichand is a bit aggressive and always trying to take the control. He has this wrist touch play, which has the ability to put opponent under tremendous pressure and always guessing where the shot is coming. Yeah, so the last moment change what he does was absolutely phenomenal. You see, Peter Gade is always guessing. He has been guessing, always guessing. Absolutely fantastic shot. So let me rewind a bit this last shot and take you through the playback speed of 0.5 and then give you a spotlight. Last moment change, absolutely phenomenal, right? Phenomenal. So this is the power of Gopichand. So he was able to give that last moment changes where opponent was in one direction and then going to a different direction. Like this, he has scored many, many points like that. As you can see again on the replay. Yeah, absolutely fantastic. When you see Gopichand play from the net, it's always at least 70% of the time a second shot. Look at that. It was not the direct shot. Second, he always stops his racket. Can you believe he has taken a point from a flick from the forehand side? And even during the service, so the service part I will definitely talk about. The service, he has taken two straight points from the service at a very crucial period that I'm going to highlight on the last part. But you see, whenever the rally happens, a long rally happens, Gopichand is always trying to play the downward stroke and take the net as much as possible so that he has this amazing deception from the net and put the opponent always in a different direction. Yeah, like that. There you go. A very soft shot. And then, yeah. And he also has this very deceptive smashes, which where the body is in one direction, it is indicating, it is depicting that he is hitting to a single direction, but the shuttle goes to a different direction. Let me try. There you go. He has always maintained, Gopichand has always maintained this game too much on the straight side and try and put the opponent not from the center, but take the opponent somewhere here and take somewhere here and then play probably a downward stroke here. Yeah. Then the downward stroke here. That's how he has been playing the smashes. Yeah, again. He uses the both techniques where he keeps pushing the player on one corner and then try to put the shuttle on the other corner. Constantly the player is moving, mixing the left and right, the left and right, and left and right. And then all of a sudden, a surprise cross stroke, which is completely out of position for the opponent. Net gain is just expertly played. There you go. Yeah, that's the thing I'm saying. The smash is on the other one side. And the direction is on one side and the smash is on one side. Yeah. See, there you go. Now this is the part which I was talking about. Look at the service. And there you go. He got decepted in the service too. It was like a service to the back forehand corner, but all of a sudden he changed the direction. And that too, mind it, the score was 14-15, second game. Beautiful overhead cross shot, cross drop shot. You never know what is Gopichand trying to do from behind the court and when he gets the shuttle in front of the court. Just pure deception. And this is where you need to watch it now. And there you go. That's a tap. Fantastic. This was a game changer. Pure brilliance. This is where Gopichand won this semifinals, and it was not easy to play with Peter Gate because he is also a very deceptive player. But that looked like Gopichand completely dominated this game, and he had an action plan and he executed that and won the match. He found himself. He surprised himself into the finals. So when in the finals, you can see his opponent Chen Hong from China, and he has played quite a good round. Hendravan, former world number one, and he has beaten him second game quite easily. And there you see, this was a very dramatic match, I can say, and it was all over. It was all over this, and a three-game dramatic match which went to the third game, and he played none other than the Malaysian hero Roslin Hashim, Muhammad Roslin Hashim, And that match was quite a big and long, dramatic. I think after that match, Chen Hong was really tired. And it's definitely not easy to recover in the next 24 hours. So he had to play the finals in the next 24 hours. And that served as an advantage for Pullela Gopichand. And Gopichand's game is more of deceptive, as you saw with Peter Gate. The same formula he had to use with Chen Hong. Although the battle was pretty hard for the first 7 to 8 points, but Chen Hong had no clue. It clearly looked in the match that he was really tired. His legs was not that quick and fast as you could see before the semifinals. There is this strange typical Chinese, I would say, way of playing the game, direct attacking, all the time attacking. That was not here. You could see that Gopichand was always trying to play that shot. Wow. A straight point from an overhead drop shot. There was always, you know, one shot. Now you can see, I'll just take a shot here. This was the place. You can never expect when Gopichand is playing a shot. This was the shot, a smash at this corner. Usually anyone can expect a smash here, or this place, or it could be even here or this place. This is the smash. You never know what angle and what direction the shuttle is coming. There you go. And the length was very good. Both the players, yeah. Did you see that? Let me just replay here. There is a constant slow game going on, and there's a good rally happening, and all of a sudden, Gopichand pushed the shuttle on his body. Constantly 2-3 shuttles on his body. There you go. Yeah. There was a proper change of pace, you could see. A long rally with a good length, and all of a sudden a straight flat shot on his body. Brilliant. Can see corner to corner. There you go. That's right. Yeah, look at this rally. So you can see Gopichand trying to do again the flick tosses and put Chen Hong under the guess situation, and forehand, there you go. Yeah, from the back and forward corner. Yeah, it's too deceptive for a player or his opponent to guess which direction the shuttle might come. That's an enormous pressure, because you're always guessing. You can see there is no solid speed from Chen Hong. I think because of the last match, he must have got tired and the legs would have given up. And the game has slowed down now. This is what Gopichand has to play. not push the pace too hard, and then the flick toss again. Yeah. Then again toss. Stop them. Yeah. Let's go. Yeah. Now Gopichand is trying to play all the shots behind and mix it up whenever it's possible. And try, he plays the strange flick tosses to the forehand or the backhand corners. And yeah, there you go, the flick cross drop. And yeah, so this is where the flick toss comes. As you can see, it's completely on this side of the court. And Chen Hong is expecting a shot somewhere here. But you can see that Chen Hong is completely out of position. Yeah. And then you get a deceptive smash. There you go. And this is the final match point. And he wins the most awaited, most prestigious All England Championship. This is what happens. Now, this is what I want you all to understand, how Gopichand smartly strategizes his opponents and outrights his opponents. He has this unique pattern, which is pattern one. Let me give you a pattern one and pattern two. And this pattern always, most of the time, always, I would say more than 75%, he uses this strategy of playing the shuttles mostly towards the first side of this part of the court. And then the strategy two is completely mixing to all the corners, just in all the corners. So then what happens is, for opponent, they really have to look forward for which direction the shuttle is coming. And slowly from the center part, if this is the center part, let me draw the center part. If this is the center part, and the player, opponent, instead of standing in the center, will move to this side. And then a forehand cross shot will gain an ace point. So this is how the one and two strategy, which I have found has been very useful for Gopichand, and especially in the semifinals and finals, he used that very brilliantly, mixing it up, using the second strategy here, and then getting the opponent on the 30 or 40% of the side court, this side court, and then completely mixing it. Brilliant. Okay, now there you go. So these are the five simple smart strategies with which P. Gopichand used in his All England semi-finals as well as finals. So I have consolidated these 5 points. I think you can apply this in your game if you are a player or if you are a coach, whenever you're training your kids or your players. So make sure that, you know, you give them these strategies to apply in the matches. And that's it from the today's Smart Badminton podcast. And I will definitely come up with a new player, with a new smart strategy and technical analysis. Until then, see you. Take care. And before I say bye, please like, comment, share, and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.